Guys, good morning. Hello. Welcome. It's the day of the MAGA stream that we've all been waiting for like 24 hours. Guys, listen, all the support so far has been unreal. Thank you so much. But we got a sick, sick lineup. And of course, the lovely lady, she's here live and in person. Look at this. It's Amanda. Amanda, how are we doing? To kick things off, I kind of want to just give you the reins here. I want you to talk about, from your perspective, what did you think of me when you first met me? How'd we meet? And all that kind of good stuff. So can you give us a little bit of a background?
We met originally in 2015. He kept asking me out on dates for about 3.5, 4 years. Two years ago now, I finally said yes to a date.
2 years after, yep, just wanted to throw that one out there. For you, when I was telling you, hey, I, you know, am putting so much money into Top Shot and all that kind of jazz, what was your initial thoughts about it? How did you handle it? Looking back at that process, do you think that you would have handled it differently, or are you more open to it now, or give us the lowdown?
So when you first told me that you were doing it, I cried because our whole plan was to buy a house. And I was like, oh my God, he's putting everything that we have saved into crypto, specifically Bitcoin was the first thing. I eventually got over it. He showed me the money that he was making with Bitcoin. And I was like, okay. And my biggest worry was, are you actually able to withdraw the money? You need to make sure you can get your money out. We're trying to save for a house. And when he was able to withdraw, I was like, okay, you can keep adding money if you want. Just make sure you don't put every penny that you have into it just in case. But yeah, just the whole money aspect. I was freaking out because the whole point was us trying to build or buy a house. And then he's taken everything that we own and put it into that.
Well,
I was also
okay.
Fine with it,
hold
too.
Hold on. Everything that we own. It was my money, too.
Because I... What?
No. I was just saying that was my money, too. To an extent, right? Because I was like, okay, like, we're in, like, a pretty good living situation and all that kind of stuff. So did that irk the hell out of you? That like, totally pissed you off, didn't it?
I go to work every single day. I'm saving for a house. And then I was like, you're putting everything that we own into something that is so unsure of. And then so I only put $500 into crypto because I didn't even feel comfortable with that. I put $500 in, I think, like October, November. And now today I've only made $500.
Well, you doubled it though.
I doubled it, but still.
For our first date, do you remember how you didn't look at me? You had the AC absolutely blaring the entire time. What do you remember from that first date?
Well, I was hella nervous because the first thing that I thought of was I turned you down for like 3.5, 4 years. And I was like, this is so awkward now because I'm like, you're going to bring this up, which you did bring it up. So I was like, this is awkward. He thought I was the weirdest person because I had the AC blasting and our first date was in the winter. So he's like, why the frig do you have your AC blasting when it's the middle of winter? But like now he knows I like to sleep when it's like super, super cold. Like we have, I think how many fans? 3 fans in the bedroom plus the window open. So now he gets it. But at the first time he was like, this is so weird that you're sitting in a car with the AC blasting.
Yeah. But. And now it's not really awkward at all. It's pretty funny how it goes from that to just being super, super comfortable for you. Obviously, like I quit my job. I'm now wanting to pursue this. And I think there's a lot of other people that might be looking in the same boat. And I've had DMs from people that said, oh, we're going to try to tune in, you know, kind of together with my significant other. Would you have any advice or things that you would want to mention for anyone that's sitting out there and they might, you know, be going into the space where they invest kind of a lot of money together into something that, you know, is volatile in a way?
Yeah, I would make sure that if you're going to do this, as like a couple, make sure that you're open and honest with your significant other. So I'm a full-time nurse, so I have a good income. I have a good job. It's very stable. And so with that, Steven was able to probably put way more money into this than what he could have done. Like if we were not together, he's always said like, I would not have invested into this. Or if I did invest, it would have just been a very, very small amount because I don't have that financial stability. And also, Steven has always worked. He's always worked like multiple jobs at once. He's always put like money in that he's like, if I lose this money, I won't be afraid or I won't be worried. because I have additional savings from working. So you just have to be open and honest and know what you're putting in and what you can take out and what you can afford to lose.
Awesome advice, Amanda. Mr. Allen just brought up with the hearts with the nurses. Guys, can we get some hearts, some W's for the nurses, the frontline workers? Come on right now. It's tough out there, Amanda. We really appreciate you doing the things that you do. So Snazzy was asking, what did you think when I quit my job one Friday evening?
In all honesty, I was probably one of the ones pushing for him to quit because obviously living with him and being his girlfriend, I've seen like the whole other side to him that you guys don't see. He puts everything into something when he does it, and he wasn't putting everything into his other job plus this. He was doing like a half-ass job basically for each. And so I was probably one of the biggest persons to be like, you need to do something. You either need to do your Monday through Friday job full-time and quit this, or you need to do this full-time and quit your Monday through Friday job.
So here's the thing with it, like, just to kind of relate to everything, when Top Shot was really taking off, there was a point where when things went LE, we've talked about this on the stream before, for like the 7500, so the Kevin Durant, the LeBron, Trey's, Kawhi, all of them were like $2 to $3, $5 even at one point. And then everything went LE in the middle of a night after the site came back from maintenance and Drew was up. And I was like, oh my God, I think I could have made like an absolute ton if I was just up then. And that was one of the few nights that I wasn't up super late. So it's very interesting to see kind of the dynamics of everything for you. Have you opened up to the crypto space whatsoever? Are you still skeptical of some things? Where is your head at for somebody that's not, you know, really invested heavily into it personally?
For me personally, I would never be able to put money into it. I know it works, but it's just, I'm so safe and I have such like a wall built up with it that I'm like, at any given moment, things could crash. And if it crashes, I can't afford to lose that.
Right. So when we're having the reports and everything that you can, you know, buy a Tesla with Bitcoin and stuff, do you feel personally that adds any legitimacy to it, or do you need to see more than that to kind of, you know, potentially jump in?
Yes and no. Like, at the same time, I see how you can buy a Tesla using Bitcoin, but I'm very logical and I think things through. So the way I think of it is, if I bought a Tesla, and just say a Tesla, I'll make it $50,000. If a Tesla is $50,000 and Bitcoin is, one Bitcoin is 50,000, we'll just put each one at 50,000. If I paid for that Tesla and then just say Bitcoin skyrocketed and now Bitcoin, one Bitcoin, let's just say, is worth $500,000, I'd be like, I was so stupid. Whereas if I use regular, we're in Canada, so I'll use Canadian dollars, and I spent 50,000 Canadian dollars and bought that Tesla for 50,000, I know that my money didn't appreciate.
And so Coffee Attack brings up an interesting point, because when I got into Top Shot, I wasn't originally streaming or anything like that. It was just, I see this as something that's about to really take off. So obviously I put a fair bit of money into it. But do you think that you would have been less supportive of me if I didn't have the Twitch channel and was starting to pursue that?
I feel like it wouldn't have. I feel like you streaming, doing your stuff with Top Shot, in a way has made you made very stupid decisions, because with some things that you've done, you're like, oh, it makes great content on the stream, which, yes, it makes great content, but if you weren't streaming, you wouldn't have made those stupid decisions.
Okay, what's my best quality?
Are we doing, like, physical or just,
oh,
like,
my God, it doesn't matter.
Well, no.
You pick.
It's the gun show, baby.
Just in general, sure. Just in general.
Your humor.
Okay, awesome. All right. Thank you so much, Amanda. We'll connect with you in a little bit. I honestly really appreciate you taking the time today.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
Bye. Not bad, eh? That was amazing. That was really, really fun. Love it.